Io Shirai versus Candice LeRae. So I thought the wrestling up to this point in the show was just top level. This was like a good TV main event level match, which is good. I'm enjoying it, but everything else I thought was better than this to this point. And then...
Hold on a second. You thought the Kushida Velveteen Dream match was better than this match?
I enjoyed it more. Now, part of that may be because I was skipping shit to get caught up. I was basically watching... At this point, I had watched like 90 minutes straight of wrestling. I was a little burned out. As it turns out, everyone, skipping shit to get caught up is not the best way to watch a wrestling show. You need spaces in between matches. So, anyway, that's my opinion. You may laugh me off like Granny if you want to. That's fine. Regardless, however you felt about it, I'm assuming, Bryan, you liked it a lot less in the last 5 minutes.
Actually, I thought this match was really good.
All right, well... The referee gets bumped, then he gets bumped again, and then Candice makes a cover, even though there's no referee there, and she saw the guy go out. Johnny runs out. Mysteriously, he has a heel ref shirt on. And oh no, he is not just a heel ref, but he's a dumb heel ref who stops counting when the babyface actually kicks out at two, even though he's fast counting anyway. So the ref comes to, goes to Johnny, demands Johnny give him the shirt back. That's my shirt, he says. Even though the referee is still wearing his shirt. So Candice is a belt shot for two, and Io kicks out of that. And then Io wins the moonsault and the Spanish fly. And like I said, it was a good match until the ref got bumped and Johnny came out, and then became, well, I'm watching WWE horseshit again.
Oh, man, I thought this match was great. Io Shirai is great. Candice LeRae is great. Candice LeRae is so good at the little things in between all of the moves. I don't know if you... Clearly you did not notice this, but she's great. And the ref bump... Okay, the first ref bump was nothing. The second ref bump was fucking great. If you're going to bump a referee, this is how you bump a referee. Io goes up top. She goes for a moonsault. Candice gets the knees up. Io bounces off of her knees halfway across the ring into the ref, who is knocked out of the ring to the floor. That was great. So, Johnny comes in with a ref shirt. He's clearly not a referee. Io still is not going to stay down for 3 seconds with his idiot counting. She kicks out. Then the other referee, yes, was demanding you take my shirt off. I don't know why he said that. Maybe he normally wears two shirts, but it was a hot day. I don't know. But anyway, Candice hits Io with the belt. Io kicks out. Johnny's selling... of her kicking out by taking multiple bumps on the ramp like he was Ric Flair. That was fucking great. And then Io hits a Spanish fly off the top, moonsault pin. I thought this match was great. Now, I didn't think it was not great, but when the match was over, Toni Storm appears on the big screen.
Mm-hmm.
And Toni Storm alerts us that she's back in NXT and she is here to turn this place upside down and inside out. And everybody cheers. She's back. Everything is great. She gets off the screen. I thought, wow, well, we finished this match. Io won. We're moving on to a new challenger. Suddenly, Ember Moon returns.
The mystery motorcycle rider we've been seeing for the past 2 weeks.
Yes.
Arrives at the building, walks out, and yes, it is in fact Ember Moon.
It is not Bo Dallas.
No, it's not Bobby Roode.
No.
Apparently she decided she will never beat Asuka, so she'll go back to NXT.
So she comes back, and then she's returning at the same time.
Yeah.
So I didn't hate it, but, I mean, it just seems like such common sense. If you want either Ember or Toni Storm's return to be important, why do they return back-to-back in the exact same segment?
Yeah.
Who am I supposed to be excited about, Toni Storm or Ember Moon? Both?
It was strange. They were set up to steal each other's thunder. It was definitely one segment because Io Shirai was never even left the ring. She was as bewildered as the rest of us, I think.
Yes.
Yeah, that is definitely strange, and it wasn't like a disaster or anything, but it's certainly not how I would have done it.